can. I couldn't take it. I'm not going to be putting myself in that kind of a compromising position, so I left. Now I come here this week. They're supposed to have security beefed up. They got all these. They got me. They got Arn Anderson, the enforcer. They got Big Bubba. They got Scott Flash Norton. They got all the security around the ring here. They got Barbarian. They got, in the back, they're all full of security. But I made it here. Now, where is Eric Bischoff? I've been standing back there with my thumb in my mouth, waiting for something to happen. Nobody shows up. What am I supposed to do? Will somebody give me some direction here?
Well, usually we see Eric around, what, 10 a.m. or so on the days of Nitro. We did not see him.
Tony.
As of 2 o'clock, we didn't see him. But Eric.
Maybe they got him.
Tony, Eric doesn't miss things.
No, you're right.
Eric would be here.
You're right.
This is a corporate takeover. He would be here. Something has happened. Now I'm here. Now can anybody guarantee me security?
Well, I can only say that I feel pretty secure out here with these guys.
Well, but then you stay here and feel secure.
Look,
well, wait a minute.
I'm busy here.
What are you saying?
I'm saying I'm here.
Hey, wait a minute. They're all going in the ring. That's Benoit. There's McMichael.
I'm getting out of here.
The Four Horsemen.
Brain is leaving again. They are trying to break the leg of the Booty Man. Flair is holding on to the figure four. Benoit and McMichael.
Hey, being a friend of Hulk Hogan is not a healthy thing around WCW anymore. Booty Man finding out the hard way.
The Dungeon of Doom doing nothing. Like we said earlier, they are allowing manners to take their course on the inside, keeping only the outsiders out. Much to the dismay of obviously the Booty Babe Kimberly and the Booty Man on the inside. The referee ducked over the top rope. Down to the mat on the outside. They are not finished yet with the Booty Man.
No, they just dislocate that knee, yanking it all over. McMichael's dropped on it. Flair's got it stretched on. Arn Anderson nailed him with the chair.
This is a message to Hulk Hogan, I know. This is a message as well to the Booty Man. This is a message to the NWO. If you want the sneak attack, we will take care of anyone. Not necessarily saying that the Booty Man is any part of this. I have no idea. Don't kick me again. He's sick. You're a sick man.
I see everybody's losing control here. Nobody trusts anybody. I'm amazed the Dungeon of Doom and members of the Four Horsemen are all here right now and it's not breaking down.
Gene Okerlund is in the ring. Gene Okerlund is in the ring. And Flair is not finished with the figure four. And Mongo is... I've never seen anything like this in my life.
All right, Edison, stop this carnage right now. We've had enough of it. After last week, I can't believe it. You know, you were a victim last week. This week, you're a perpetrator.
Intense pain is a wonderful thing, Gene Okerlund. Your life flashes before your eyes. Things that are the most important to you become crystal clear.
Look at this.
You start to begin to learn the meaning of life. Last week, when they stuffed me in that ambulance, and I looked across and I saw Flair, Sting, Woman, Bagwell, and myself, I realized that we were people brought together, not by philosophy, but by necessity. And I started to think, New World Order, New World Order, where have I heard that? And I remembered in the good book, it says, when the New World Order is put into place, it signals the beginning of the end of time. Well, WCW is our world. It's where we live and breathe. And if you want to destroy it, Hogan and the Outsiders, you've already made a mistake that jumps off the page. You're going to take a baseball bat to a horseman. Finish the job, because there's one rule of gang fighting. See, we are the original gang, and we're the most vicious in all of professional wrestling history. They send one of yours to the hospital. You send one of theirs to the morgue.
Chris Benoit.
Last Monday, Nitro, people thought they seen the Crippler about to break down. Distraught. What they did see was a fury of hatred, anger, and vengeance unleashed.
We saw a little bit of that. Chris Benoit, of course, to be in action in Sturgis on Saturday night. Steve,
you saw what happened last week.
You saw
what they perpetrated on AA, baby. Well, let me tell you what, Outsiders. You better get it together, because I've been known to swing a little metal myself. And you better grow eyeballs in the back of your head, because when that hair raises on the back of your neck, turn around quick. It'll be the Four Horsemen, baby.
Thank you, Ric Flair. Ric, nature boy.
Come here. Hogan, wherever you are,
Watch this! Ric Flair sending a message to Hulk Hogan and the New World Order because of the association between the Voodoo Man.
Tell Hogan! Tell him! Tell him! Send the word! We take it! AJ! Hogan! You want our attention? You just got it! Huh? You think because you woke up one day, you became a bad man? You're so wrong. You have made a mistake. This is my best friend. And you, you crossed the line, pal. And now, wherever you are, you're going to pay the price. There's your best friend. Come get him, big boy. Come get him.
Are you through now?
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Ric Flair. Stay tuned. We've got more Nitro live from Orlando when we come back.
Anytime, pal.
He's around, believe me.